You ever seen a cop get arrested in full uniform on his way to his shift? Me neither. Let's talk about it. Yo, it's your boy Colorado Marley, that guy mile high floating. Whatever you know me as, you know what I'm saying? Because we've had a long YouTube journey, you dig? We've had to become real YouTube friendly these days. Anyways, let's jump right into this. I ain't about to sit here and talk your head off. I want to see how this cop gets arrested in full uniform on his way to work, bruh. It don't even make no sense. I don't know if it's a DUI, if it's a... I mean, that's probably the most likely, actually. That's probably the most likely. That's probably what it is. Let's go ahead and check this out, bro, and see what's going on. Shout out to Cop Watch TV. The link to the description to the original video is going to be down below. So if you want to watch it without my commentary and me talking, have at it. But if you like my commentary and you want to hang out with you, bro, then come hang out with you, bro. You know what I'm saying? Let's go. Go.
Stand right here. Yep, on my light. Face your
See, look,
toes together.
Right on the money.
It's
a DUI or DWI, whichever one he's gonna get charged with.
A New Mexico State police officer was on duty when he observed an Albuquerque Police Department police unit driving at a high rate of speed. The APD police unit was also drifting in and out of lanes. The state police officer turned on his lights to initiate a traffic stop. The Albuquerque police officer flashed his lights but pulled over.
You want to know the craziest part about this? As a civilian, if I was riding down the highway and I seen another cop pulling over a cop, I don't know what I would do at that moment. Like, I feel like I would feel like the Matrix just broke. You know what I'm saying? Like, we just snapped out of whatever, you know, imaginary world we've all been living in or some shit. You know what I'm saying? We just unplugged from some shit. Like, the Matrix was fake. You know what I mean? Like, that just, it wouldn't comprehend in my brain that that's what just happened. I would just keep driving. Like, they just, buddy wanted to talk to him. Like, I would, like, my brain would not be able to go to this cop just pulled that cop over because that cop thought this cop was doing something he shouldn't have been doing in a cop car. That wouldn't have been my thought process. I'm just throwing that out there. I'm just saying, I'm gonna just keep it a buck with you.
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good. What's the hurry?
I'm just in my way to work. I have like 9-11 minutes left.
You have 5 minutes left?
Yeah, okay. I win at 12.
Okay. What?
You're not staying in your lane.
I'm sorry, boss, I have a low tire. That's all it is.
Come back here and talk to me real quick.
Yeah. No. I can't. I got it. What did he say when he first answered the question? What?
How's it going?
Good. How are you?
Good. What's the hurry?
I'm just in my way to work. I have like 9-11 minutes left.
Like 9 minutes left. I think he was trying to say I have 11 minutes to get to work. That's what he was trying to say. But it came out 11 minutes left. Sir, might want to not be driving.
Miss left?
Yeah.
Okay. You can't even speak straight.
And also, you're not staying in your lane.
I'm sorry, boss. I have a low tire. That's all it is.
Come back here and talk to me real quick.
Yeah, he's definitely drunk. A low tire. He's like dragging letters out and stuff when he's trying to pronounce words. He's definitely drunk. Definitely.
Come back here. Yep. Over here. Yeah, stand right here. Did you see me on the freeway?
I didn't see you. I'm sorry.
Okay. You didn't see me at all?
No, sir.
You didn't see me at all?
No, I didn't.
Okay, were you doing a buck 12 and I turned around? I actually saw you in the median and I turned around. Okay. And I've been chasing you probably since the 212-ish.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Buck 12?
Did you do a favor? You have your weapon on you, right?
What's that?
You have your weapon on you?
Yes, sir.
Let's put it in your car real quick. Okay. And your taser.
Bruh. You know, one thing I can say, though, shout out to this cop. Shout out to this cop for who's pulling over the other cop. Shout out to him, because the fact that he's still holding this cop to the same standard that he's holding every other civilian to, like, I appreciate that. I'm just gonna throw it out there. I appreciate that. I ain't gonna sit here and try to sugarcoat it, try to say some buts or some anything. No, I appreciate that he's holding this other cop accountable for his actions, because that's exactly what he would have did if you went driving by at a buck 12. You dig what I'm saying? Accountable. I like it. I like it.
Come back here.
Yes, sir.
Over here. When does shift start?
12, sir.
12? Okay, start here. So, Mr. Hernandez, where are you coming from?
Las Lunas.
Where do you live at in Las Lunas?
What's that?
Where do you live at?
Hunting Ranch.
Hunting Ranch?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mr. Hernandez, like, I tried to put your gun away. Okay, let me flat out honest with you. Okay, one, you're speeding.
Yes, sir.
With no lights on.
Yes, sir.
Two, I don't know why you keep going off the road. That's why I stopped you.
Honestly, can I show you why?
Well, you can tell me why.
It's because I don't have my other light or my other key, and so my other key, like, it fucks me up because I don't have my other key in the ignition, and so it's pulling on my belt. That's why. Like,
what?
I can show you, sir.
So that's why you can't stay in one lane?
No.
Okay, no. I asked you, why can't you stay in one lane?
Because I'm trying to log on to all my stuff and everything like that.
Okay. So when did you start logging into it?
Honestly, I can show you. Like, I've been trying to log on and doing all my other stuff. That's the only reason.
Mr. Nannis, when did you last drink alcohol?
Yesterday.
Okay, I'm gonna check your eyes real quick.
Okay.
Put your toes together.
Bruh.
I'm gonna check my flashlight.
There was a whole lot of things that was not making sense in that situation. I got real caught up in the moment in that situation trying to understand what Buddy was saying, because he definitely wasn't answering the question that other Buddy just asked. It was one of the moments where it was like ducking and dodging, and you know what I'm saying? Like, what is it? What are you really trying to say, bro? Like, what are you really trying to say? You're faded. Maybe not faded. We won't say that. You're definitely not in the right state of mind. You're a little intoxicated. You shouldn't be behind the wheel, bruh.
What time yesterday?
Probably 12 midnight
or
noon.
12 noon?
Yes, sir.
Okay, noon yesterday?
Yes, sir.
So, like, 12 hours ago?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
No. Like, noon the day prior.
Okay, I'm gonna check your eyes. Okay. So, nothing to drink recently?
No, sir.
Okay, any major head injury?
Just a headache recently, but that, nothing crazy.
Okay. When did you graduate the academy?
about 3 years.
Just a headache recently, but nothing crazy. You know what that headache was? It's called a hangover. That's what happens when you drink too much. Hangovers are a thing for everybody when you drink too much. I'm just saying. We ain't about to sit here and elaborate on a hangover. But it's a hangover, sir. Don't try to beat around the bush.
Okay. Was I one of your instructors?
What's that?
Was I one of your instructors?
No, sir.
Okay. See my fingertip?
Yes, sir.
Follow my fingertip with your eyes only. Don't move your head.
Yes.
So, Mr. Hernandez, can you explain why I would smell alcohol from your breath?
I don't know why, sir.
Okay. Here we go. Don't move your head.
Dang, that's it right there. He said, why would I smell alcohol from your breath? You did it. You did it, buddy.
Mr. Hernandez, do you have a license?
On me, yeah.
Can I see it? Who's your sergeant?
Sergeant Folk. Jared Folk.
Okay. Wait right there. This is very awkward for me, Mr. Hernandez.
That sucks. Here, let's see. Let's scoot up. I want to get to the part where he starts doing the field sobriety tests.
Stand right there.
I don't care about him running his name. He's a cop. He's on his way to work.
Toes together?
Yes, sir.
He didn't have no warrants or none of that nonsense.
Follow my fingertip. Don't move your head.
There's a slight little movement in his head. See, This is the thing. We've watched a lot of these videos, and that slight little baby movement that he's got going on in his head when the dude's going back to the left, his right, however you'd be looking. I don't know, because you know sometimes the video be looking a little inverted. Regardless, when he's going back and forth, there's a slight movement in his head where he's not just moving his eyes. That, in all the other videos we've seen, that's enough right there. You failed. You dig? You failed. You did not pass. You're going to jail. We're going to see, though. We're going to see how fair, how lenient this cop is with this other cop. Because right there, that he would have failed. That's it. You're going to jail, bro. You ain't going to work. You're going to jail. I'm just saying. In any other situation, that's how it'd play out. Yeah, look, there's that movement, man. He got a little, he got a movement in his head when he's doing that. Look, he even told him, don't move your head. Bruh, your eyeballs is dancing. They ice skating in your head, bruh. Them things is ice skating in the eye sockets, bruh. They look a little glossy. You look like you want to cry a little bit. You know, he's holding it back, but he want to cry a little bit. He gonna be like, it's something in my eye. There's just something in my eye, Sarge. Just something in my eye, Sarge. You moved your head up just a little bit.
Can you run us two more quick tests? We'll possibly get you on your way. Any problems walking, bouncing, or turning?
He ain't gonna dock him for them crazy. That head movement?
Those what you use every single day?
Relatively. I changed the insoles on them, but...
Yep, on my light. Yes, sir. Face your police unit, put your heel and toes together. Right now, the only thing I want you to do is listen to me, okay? Okay. Can you imagine a straight line from your left foot to my right foot? Can you imagine a straight line?
I'm sorry, which way?
Just imagine straight line from your left foot.
You
to my
do
right
this,
foot.
Dog. What do you mean? He shouldn't just, even have to for real tell you anything.
Just imagine a straight line. Okay. Well, don't move your foot. Okay. Don't move your foot. Put your feet together. Okay. Okay. Imagine. Okay. Don't do anything. Just imagine.
Buddy failed. That's it. That's it. There's nothing else to say about the situation. Even if you know, dude wanted to be a little lenient on the last test, you failed the shit out of this one right now. I did, bro. If he don't fail this goddamn sobriety test, there's no justice, dog. There's no justice, bro. There's no way that he can't go to jail today. You failed. You sucked at that one right there. You ain't even started the test and you failed it. And the thing that's even crazier is you administer these types of tests. So you should know this shit like the back of your hand regardless. He shouldn't even have to be telling you none of this. You should be able to just do this. Let me moonwalk this motherfucker. Yeah, let me moonwalk it for you. Let me moonwalk it. Yeah. I'm just saying. Just saying.
From your left foot to my right foot. Can you do that? Okay, the line with your foot or shoe is about 4 to 5 inches wide. Turn down, do me a favor. On that imaginary line, place your left foot just like this. Okay. Go ahead and do it for me now. Mr. Hernandez. No.
Sorry.
That was your right foot. I said place your...
Sorry. I can't hear you.
Okay. Now, Mr. Hernandez, place your right foot directly in front of your left, touching the other toe. Like, directly in front. At your sides.
Can I take off my mats? I can't see it over my back.
Sure, go ahead.
Okay. Can I put them on your hood?
You can put them in your car.
Okay. Sorry, I can't see over my hood. Or my...
You don't know where your feet at. Like, the craziest part about this is just that it's going on so long. Like, bruh, arrest this man. He's drunk. He's on his way to work. He's a cop. He's supposed to be protected and serving. It's not what he's doing. He's not in any capacity to do that at this exact moment. Arrest this man. Take him to jail.
Three. I took three. You will take nine. Once you take 9 steps, you'll make a turn. Keep your front foot.
You've had to explain this too many times to a person who does this. Why are you still talking to him?
And now you're facing my patrol unit. Mr. Hernandez, do you understand the turning process? After you turn, you'll take 9 more heel toe steps down that same line, just like this. 1, 2, 3, back down number 9.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Hernandez, throughout this test, keep your hand directly at your sides.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, not in your pockets.
Yes, sir.
Look down at your feet while you count, and count out loud so I can hear you. Also, once you start this test, don't stop it until you've completed it, and don't forget to touch heel to toe.
Okay.
Any questions?
No, sir.
You feel yourself what I want you to do?
Yes, sir.
Next up will be step number 1.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Bruh, I think he already failed. I mean, we know he failed, but I'm pretty sure he miscounted right off the bat, bro. I'm pretty sure he missed count it. Yeah, hold up. Let's watch this one more time.
Chill the toe. Okay. Any
I'm
questions?
Pretty sure he didn't count the first step, for real.
Next up, maybe step number 1.
Look.
1.
See, no. You miscounted, dog. The first, that first one when you go up, that should have been 1, 2, right? I'm pretty sure. I guess I've never had to do a field sobriety test, so if I'm wrong, correct me down in the comments below. But I'm pretty sure he just miscounted one of his steps. I'm just saying. Just throwing it out there.
Completed it. And don't forget to touch heel to toe.
Okay.
Any questions?
Any questions?
What I want you to do?
No.
Yes, sir.
Next up will be step number 1.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Okay, turn and face me. Put the toes together. Hands on your sides.
Can we do it on the other side of your unit? It's super windy.
What's that?
Can we do the other test on the side of your unit?
No, we're state police. Everything's done in our front.
Okay, that's fine. I mean, it's super windy.
Oh, gotcha.
Okay.
I did the test.
Okay.
No,
I'm just saying that.
Okay. You gotcha. You could turn however you need to.
Okay.
So just watch me. Don't start yet. Just right now. I want you to listen to me.
Bruh. Okay, so there's just way too much going on as far as red flags that he hasn't been arrested yet.
Approximately 6 inches parallel with the ground.
Yes, sir.
Do you know what parallel means?
Do the next test. Let's move on to the next test.
Look down the foot that's elevated and count out loud.
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir.
Do you fully understand?
Yeah. Can I?
Sure. You can face whichever way you want. Whenever you're ready, I'll tell you when to stop.
1001, 1002, 1003. Look, you want to know, on this test, the wind might be playing as a disadvantage in this situation. Because he is not still at all. And it's probably because of the wind. I'm going to give him that one. He still failed the mother test, though. He still failed the other two. I don't care. Take his ass to jail. Because you can't protect and serve and be drunk at the same time. It just don't work that way, player.
Okay, come over with me. Can you count backwards?
Yes, sir.
Count backwards from the number 58 to 43 backwards.
Yes, sir.
Don't sing them.
Don't sing them?
Yeah, just count backwards.
Okay. 58, 57, 56, 58 to where?
43,
okay. 58, 57, 56, 55, 54, 53, 52, 51, 50, 49, 48, 47, 47, 47, 48, 47, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48, 47, 48,
There ain't not, I don't think there's one person on the planet that don't sing it to remember it. That's how we're taught it. That's how we remember that forever, for life. It's because you sing it. Even when he was sitting there, look, this is how I would have did it. This is how I would have did it. You want me to do that? You don't sing it? I'm going to sing it in my mind so that I can reiterate it back to you without singing it. You know what I'm saying? That's how I would have, well, I would have tried that. I would have tried that. It may not have worked. I'm just saying. That would have been my strategy, though.
DQR.
Okay. Unfortunately, Mr. Hernandez, I believe that you're well over the legal limit. Okay. Okay. Going to take care of you. So I will do the favor of that. Would you there disagree with me?
Told you.
I wouldn't agree with you, sir.
No, I said, would you disagree with me?
I would disagree.
Okay.
Can I put in my unit?
Sure.
Dang. Buddy got arrested. But hey, you got to be held to the same standard that the people that you're trying to protect and serve are being held to.
You're speeding.
Period, yes, point blank. You have no room for error because you are the law.
I mean, yes. Did you do great in the fields? No. Do you know how to do the field sobriety test? Yes. Your speech. I've never heard you speak. The strong odor. Your eye movements. Okay?
Okay, but my eye movement and nothing else. I'm not going to argue.
Well, I know you're not.
I'm good.
All right, now we got to see. Did we get to see him make it to the police? I'm just scanning across. We don't.
You want me to get
in? We'll come in a minute.
You honestly, you don't need to do all that. Like, I can.
Well, you should have your gun belt, yeah.
What do you want?
Were this thing?
Yeah.
Did that come off?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we're going to take it out.
Okay. Do you want me to put it in my unit?
Yeah.
Bruh, you could have did that when you was at the unit. Why didn't you take everything off? Let's walk back to the unit.
It's the
there's no key fob?
Long one, sir.
There's no key fob?
No, sir.
Did you have your phone?
Yes, sir.
It's real respectable, though. I ain't gonna lie. The dude getting arrested is super respectable. He's not, like, super arrogant. He's not sitting there trying to argue too much. Like, you know, he's saying his piece as far as I disagree. You know, he tried to ask some questions as far as, you know, what is, what cues, you know what I'm saying, did I give off that make you feel this way? You know, he asked the questions in a manner that I felt that they
was
respectful.
Yeah. Let's check out the APD.
You know, it was respectful. Damn, he got to take off the shirt too. Strip him down to his drawers. God dang.
Go.
What is, look. What is with these cops getting in trouble and getting arrested and basically getting stripped down to their drawers, bro? They get everything taken. Take it off. All of it. Jesus.
Okay, look back there.
So he gets in the handcuffs.
And or drugs.
The blah, blah, blah. Doing all the nonsense, Miranda. Let me search you.
1206, okay?
All right, when does his superior get here?
And then we'll call your sergeant.
Oh, they don't even call him
in. I got to tell him
the
tents anyway.
They don't even call in the sergeant. They just call him. Oh, that's pretty much that, huh?
Okay.
Oh, no, here's sergeant.
We'll be in a shitty situation, sir. I mean, but again, he's totally respectful. He doesn't want to blow, and it's fine. Thanks, we'll figure it out down the road. But I appreciate you coming out. All right,
appreciate it. Thanks.
Yes, sir.
Bruh,
he's right here.
You know what that we gonna figure it out down the road is? It's all right. You knew how to play the game. I'm gonna let your ass out as soon as we get to the dang thing, and then we gonna take you back to the car. That's what that meant right there. That's how I felt. That's how I took that. You know what I'm saying? I took that as we're going to get to the station. We're going to, you know, have some conversations. I'm going to talk some ish to you all the time. And we're going to take you back. You know what I'm saying? That's what that sounded like to me. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. Keep it a buck.
The 43-1 that we had last week, the knife is in my passenger front side. I just didn't get a tag yet last week, just because everything that's going on. I don't know if that's important. I just want to let you know before, if the vehicle gets towed, people lose their shit because there's a bloody knife in my unit. Okay. I just want to let you know, sir.
All right. Look, he's super respectful dude, bro. At least he's honest.
Look.
I don't got nothing bad to say about, but
APD
he just shouldn't have been drinking
Jordan
and driving.
Hernandez was charged with aggravated DWI driving while under the influence of liquor and or drugs, speeding, and failure to maintain a traffic lane.
Damn.
His trial and employment with APD is pending.
Yep. Yeah, they stripped him of everything right there. That was a... You're out of there, buddy. You're out of there. That's what that was. Anyways, let me know what you thought about that down in the comments below. Do you think it was fair? Do you think it wasn't fair? What do you think happened as far as the thing? Should we check into it after and see if Buddy got his job back? Is he still a cop? I don't know. Maybe. Maybe so. If you've already looked into it, let me know. You dig what I'm saying? Anyways, I love y'all. Catch you in the next one. And, yeah, that's all there is to that. Peace.